Frida? Frida? Where's my tea?
First, they'd ask us, what is your complaint?
And we have to say
that we are frightened. That we are badly disturbed.
But that's not enough. Don't you see? If the police had to worry about small things like that, they'd be psychiatrists, not the police.
We could say that. We can see a crime being committed.
But it's not going on right now.
Because it happened last night.
And they'd say, why didn't you call last night?
We could say that we just got a telephone connection.
And then they'd say, madam, your colony has had telephone since 1968. And anyway, what about the neighbors?
What about them?
Why haven't they called?
Maybe they have.
Well, in that case, the police have obviously ignored their complaints. So why should we waste a phone call?
But what is the harm in crying?
I just don't want to stick my neck out, that's all.
Maybe we can organize something. All together.
Oof. Who has the time for all that?
But everyone is talking about it.
Everyone who?
Kumu, Piki, Tara, Mrs. Menon, Nini.
And what are they doing about it?
Well, they are...
Right. Wringing their hands and nagging their husbands.
But no one wants to do it alone.
So why should we?
Because I am frightened. I can't bear it anymore.
Darling, what are you frightened of? Who would dare hurt you?
But I can hear them.
But sounds can't hurt you.
Oh, but they do. Those dirty, ugly sounds.
So, shut your ears. See? Like this. There. Is that better?
But the sounds come inside my nice clean house and I can't push them out. If only they didn't make such a racket, I wouldn't mind so much. And why did I have to do it here? I mean, why can't they go somewhere else?
Leela, the thing to do here is not let them disturb you so much. Pretend they're not there.
I can't help hearing them. They're so loud and rude. How can I make myself deaf just for them?
But see, I'm not deaf and I'm not disturbed by them.
I don't understand how you do it.
I don't know really. Just don't let them, I suppose. You see, that's what they want. They want to upset you. They want to frighten you. Don't you see? When you get frightened, you're just playing into their hands, doing what they want.
But how can I just stop? I don't want to feel this way. I mean, who would?
Some people might. Who knows?
Well, I don't. I feel awful. I feel sick. I can barely eat, you know. I feel so sick.
Leela, you must learn to relax. The most important thing is not to give in to them.
I can't relax! Not so long as there is that going on every night!
Look, would it make a difference to you if I call the police?
Yes. Oh yes! It would. It really would.
Tell you what, I'll call them tonight while it's actually going on. After all, it's not like a picture show or anything. There's no guarantee it'll be on tonight.
I'm sure it will. Of course. Why should it stop tonight? And they will come. Who are they?
Who?
The police. They will surely come.
Who knows? After all...
No, don't. I won't stand for it if they don't.
You never know with the police these days. They might say, it's none of our business what goes on in the next compound. After all, there's the chowkidar.
But he has been paid off. You said so yourself.
We don't know that for a fact. It was just an idea.
Maybe he is frightened too.
Maybe he enjoys it.
No, not that. No one could.
Why? Some people do.
No one could enjoy such awful things.
Except those involved.
Oh, if only I could be sure that police will come.
What about the owners of the building? Really? It's their responsibility what goes on in the next compound. That's what the police might say.
But the owners aren't there. The building has just been built. Surely, anyone can see that. It has got all its rooms and its windows and its lights. But no one is living there yet. So, no one is there to see what happens there. Except us.
And the chowkidar.
When the police come, they'll be able to see how terrible it all is. How it has invaded our life, our homes. Oh, we can't have guests for dinner.
Don't be silly. Of course we can.
But we haven't. Not for 2 weeks.
I've been away. And the children had exams.
No, it is this. I can't imagine letting someone else see it all.
Well, anyway, there's someone coming tonight.
What? You've called someone?
Yes, Mohan.
Mohan? Mohan who?
Mohan Ram, my friend from Delhi.
Who?
Remember?
Oh, your Delhi friend. But what did Mohan?
We just keep the window shut, draw the curtains, and put on some music. In fact, why don't we put some on right away?
No, 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 no! I can't bear any sounds anymore.
Leela. Leela, you mustn't react this way. Don't you see?
No, I don't see!
That's what they want, these people.
But why? Why should they? They don't know me. What have I done to them?
Baby, you must learn to ignore it now. I insist.
I can't. I can't. Don't you see that?
Do some meditation. That's always gonna help you.
It doesn't work anymore.
You probably weren't concentrating hard enough.
I am. I'm concentrating with all my mind. But it just doesn't work.
Why don't you go see that yoga teacher of yours?
If it takes so much effort to ignore something, isn't it the same thing as not ignoring it?
No. Because in your case, by not ignoring it, you're being disturbed. And that's wrong. You mustn't let these things disturb you. What does your yoga teacher tell you? That your mind must be like a...
like a cool, clear pool of water through which my thoughts can swim unchallenged. But it doesn't work. I've tried it.
I'm sure you weren't concentrating hard enough.
I was. Really, I was. I did just like my Guruji told me. I sat on a cushion there by the window and I made my mind blank. I thought of a white wall with nothing written on it. And I thought of the cosmos and of my breath coming in and out. In and out. In my mind, I said, "Oh," until my mind became absolutely quiet, absolutely calm. Oh.
It's Tony the milkman. Come for his money. Going on?
Am I going mad?
Of course not. Just oversensitive, that's all.
And who can meditate with a horrible noise outside.
But that's the time, isn't it? You must learn to block out any kind of distraction, especially while it's going on. Otherwise, what's the point?
I suppose you're right. I just have to try harder. Your friend Mohan, will he stay for dinner?
Oh, just make something simple.
There is an afternoon's leftover rice, dal.
Whatever. He's not fussy. How about parathas?
I'll see what Frida says. Far away.
How can they hurt me?
Even the sounds hurt me.
My Leela is very sensitive.
Oh.
I understand. After all, it's hardly the thing for a woman.
You shouldn't watch either, you know. You really shouldn't.
But why not? What harm is there in watching?
Someone told Leela that to watch a crime and do nothing is to... what? To be involved in yourself?
Ridiculous.
Just what I said. They are there and you are here. What's the connection?
Sushina said, if you can stop a crime, you must. Or else you're helping it to happen.
This Sushila sounds like an intellectual.
And she is.
No, she's not. She's my friend.
She's done her MA in political science.
That proves it.
No, she's not. She's very nice.
These intellectuals always react like that. Always confuse simple issues. After all, what is the harm in simply watching something? Even when there's an accident on the street, don't we all turn eyes to look?
I never look.
But Leela, supposing you had an accident and no one looked then, what would happen to you? How would you get help?
Yes. You see, it's unnatural not to look. It's unnatural not to get involved.
Are you too scared to go to their help?
Who said anything about help? I'm talking about looking. That's all.
Besides, you're the one who wants to have this thing stop.
I want the police to come and clear them away. I don't want to go there myself.
Just looking isn't the same thing as going to their help.
Well, what is screaming?
Is it for help?
Isn't it for help?
Or is it just in general? That matters, you know. After all, it could be some sort of drama.
Who can tell? With these people outside, no one can say why they do what they do.
Well, so what about your kind of screaming? For instance, was it just one person?
No. Well, yes. I think so.
But you're not sure?
But that's not the point.
But anyway, what kind of screaming was it? Was it hysterical or high-pitched?
You will hear it yourself in a minute. Why waste time talking about it?
It gives us an opportunity to compare Leela's version with the real thing.
But it's a different person every night. So how can you make a comparison?
It's a different person. You sure of that?
You know how it is. All of them outside look exactly alike.
Then how can you say it's a different person?
Well, the clothes, you know.
Oh, I hate to hear it.
Of course. Well, anyway, let's restrict ourselves to last night's case. Was it, for instance, was it high-pitched? Or to put it differently, was there an edge of hysteria?
Frida?
Things are falling. Anyway, so what I was saying was there an edge of hysteria?
I wouldn't know what hysteria sounds like.
Leela's lived a very quiet life up till now. All of this is very new to her.
How do I explain what I mean? Okay. Was it like a singer's voice? You know, high and sweet? Was it musical?
No. Not at all. In fact...
Yes?
In fact, I thought it was so horrid and gurgly.
Gurgly?
Yes. And rasping? As if whoever it was had a cold or something?
That's an important clue. Perhaps the victim is always somewhat diseased.
Oh, I don't think so. I doubt it.
Why do you say that?
Well, they all look quite healthy. Thin, but healthy.
Then why the rasping? The gurgling?
Well, after you've been screaming for a while, I suppose your voice gets sore. Of course, I wouldn't know myself.
Of course, but what you suggest is maybe the phlegm builds up.
How can you talk of these things?
And there's a fair amount of crying. So tears to add to the phlegm.
Tears? You think they're actually crying?
Well, I think so.
So rasping, gurgling, crying. I think we're getting a clearer picture of things now.
So, is it genuine screaming then?
Well, it certainly seems real enough.
And if they're really screaming for help, if it is genuine, does it mean we ourselves must go to Satan?
No, of course not. Nothing's proven yet, except that the screaming is quite possibly genuine. Or at least, it sounds genuine.
Surely, if it is, we must go?
Well, not really. You see, I don't like to get involved. Unless, of course.
Unless what?
Unless, I mean, if it's murder.
Oh, but this isn't murder.
You sure?
No. The victim is twitching and moving, even at the end.
Well then, unless it's murder, I don't think anyone should come between the members of a family.
But this is hardly private.
Well, I don't suppose so. But I don't know what it is. It can't be something private that way.
Well, how about torture then?
Well, it's much more difficult, you see. After all, what can you describe as torture? It's too vague a term I've always felt.
Man, I don't think it's torture anyway.
How can we be sure?
Well, there's always a purpose behind torture, isn't there? I mean, the police or something trying to get information from someone. I mean, it's not just random and disgusting, is it?
Usually. But then I remember reading in the Time magazine many years ago about a family who tortured someone just for the fun of it. Just a nice middle-class American family.
Imagine.
Such awful things happen in America.
But Hila's right. I don't think it's torture either.
Why do you say that?
Well, you know, torture, even when it pleases the torturer, is usually more... What's the word?
Dignified?
No.
Restrained, refined.
That's closer to it, but...
Organized? Controlled?
Yes, that's it, I think. Controlled. Whereas here, there's no control or decency at all. Wild abandon is more like it.
It's terrible.
And it's too exhibitionistic, you know, to be real torture.
Exhibitionistic? That's a very specific sort of term.
Yes. What I mean to say is, torturers usually work in secret, isn't it?
Well, not in olden times.
Exactly. But nowadays, you can't exactly come out in the open and torture someone, can you?
Whereas this...
This is in full view of three buildings.
Whereas this...
In front of decent, ordinary people like us. Really, it's terrible that such things are permitted.
Do you suppose they know you can see?
Why? Of course!
How can we be so sure?
They have asked us to turn off our lights after all.
They wouldn't have done that unless they wanted us to watch.
Wait. Asked you to turn off your lights? Is someone in contact with their spokesman then?
No! Who would speak with those creatures?
Well, not asked exactly, but...
Everyone with their lights on has got their windows smashed.
Smashed? But... That's terrible. They can be prosecuted for that.
Well, at least one person had his window smashed.
Only one. But still, you people must complain about this thing. It's an outrage. You must call the police.
The police? Why? I've been begging Bhaskar for days now.
Well, I just heard the story. Who knows if it's true?
And the man's car was covered with filth.
They say his wife and children were threatened.
How do you know all of this?
We hear it in the building.
You know how it is in these colonies. No one can keep secrets from anyone.
Well, that changes things.
Why?
I mean, if they're going to be aggressive, then where's the question of going to the hell.
But Mohan, it's not the victims who break the windows.
How can we be so sure?
Come on, why would the victims want us to watch?
They may think that they'll get help quicker that way.
I'd never thought of that. However, it's unlikely.
Why?
The victims are generally being held down.
Oh, I hate the girl.
Held down?
Yes, by the others.
What others?
You know, the assailants. There's usually around four of them.
No, don't. I don't like you even talking about it.
You've really never seen it.
Me? No, never. How could I? It would make me ill for weeks.
So, if the windows are being broken, it must be by the assailants.
The picture is growing clearer day by day. So there are different victims every day.
Mind you, we can't be certain of that.
I thought from the clothes.
Well, they're not completely clothed.
What?
You mean they're
naked. They're usually naked.
How disgusting! How terrible to be naked!
Yes, I think you did mention it to me earlier. But then, where does the question of clothes arise at all?
So, we start off clothes and then begin to lose them.
All of them?
Well,
the assailants too?
Well, the assailants tear the clothes off the victims and then, perhaps in the general excitement of things, remove their own clothes as well.
But why? Why are we talking about these things?
But Leela, we must. Or else, how are we to know whether or not to help the victims?
Oh.
So, what are the clothes of the victim like?
Oh, tatters and rags usually.
So you'd suppose that the victims are by and large poor people?
Definitely.
Isn't it terrible? Attacking the poor?
And what about the assailants? Are they poor as well?
Well, they're not rich. Their clothes are usually torn pants, t-shirts, that sort of thing.
Well, as long as it's the poor attacking the poor, you know how it is. They live their lives and we live ours.
So, we don't have to do anything?
There's also the issue, you know, of why they do it like this. Regularly, under the lights and all.
Yes, that is a strange feature. But you know, something just struck me.
What?
Are there any unusual objects around by any chance?
What an odd question.
But why?
No, I mean any sort of carved stones or figurines or anything.
Not that I can remember.
But why do you ask?
It's just that all the descriptions, the screaming, the wild abandon, the exhibitionism, even the nakedness. You know what it could be? You know what would explain everything?
You know what?
A religious ceremony. Sacred rites.
Well, surely...
No! It's too awful!
But don't you see? That would explain why no one goes to the help of the victims. Because, of course, if it's something religious, no one can interfere. Not even the police.
That's true, of course. If this is religious, then there's no stopping the thing.
Everyone would be up in arms.
Even if it's not a nice religion?
No one can say what's nice and not nice, Leela. Someone else's religion is someone else's business.
But even if it doesn't sound right?
Leela, you see, it's all a question of taste, actually. What sounds heavenly to one person might sound hellish to another.
But the screaming, if it is genuine?
Maybe to them, that's what sounds heavenly. Who can tell these days? It takes all types.
Yes, who can tell? This is a good point, Mohan. Very good. This does explain a lot.
Especially why the police haven't been caught. Or if they have, why they have done nothing about it. Can you imagine the outcry if they tried to obstruct some religious rite?
But even if it is something religious, can't it be stopped? If they're doing something really horrible.
That's the whole point of being a secular nation, Leela. No one has the right to decide that this is horrible and that is not.
Our constitution guarantees us the freedom to worship as we please.
So long as we don't offend the sensibilities of others.
But this is offending my sensibilities.
But that's because up till now, you have not realized the sacred nature of the spectacle.
But the victims, their sensibilities are being offended.
I'm not sure we can even call them victims anymore. At most, they're in pain. That's not the same as being a victim.
But isn't it wrong to be in pain?
Not if it's in the name of religion. Look at sadhus. They sit on nails or walk across smoldering coal. Look at those fast days, the flagellation with knives.
But that is people doing things to themselves. Whereas here, it is four people ganging upon one victim. Who they have agreed is genuinely screaming.
What about circumcision?
But that is different. That's, you know, I mean, parents have certain rights over their children.
Ear piercings, nose piercings, all those things hurt.
The very fact that there are always the same number of assailants, or priests now I suppose, seems to me a clear indication that you're finally on the right track. I'm almost convinced of it. It was your use of the word crying that set me off on a wrong scent altogether.
Why do you say almost convinced?
There's only one little doubt.
What?
I mean, are you sure there aren't any unusual objects around?
Wait a minute. I think I see your point. You mean ritual objects. Statues, idols, relics, that sort of thing.
Exactly. That's just what I was wondering about. You know, it does seem odd to think of a religious ceremony without any of these elements being involved.
No, why? The religions we are familiar with have those things. This may be some new sort of faith. The cult of the bodybuilders.
Would that explain why they are naked then?
Yes, and perhaps the barbarism as well. New cults can be quite violent at the outset, especially their initiation rites.
This would also explain why there's a new victim. I mean, initiate every time.
How about music? Do you hear any music?
No, only the screaming.
It probably takes time for religion to reach the hymns and chanting phase.
Still, it seems a very disgusting sort of religion.
Sheila, who are we to criticize?
After all, if we criticize others, they can criticize us. And then, where would we be?
But we are all good people. What have we done wrong? We don't go running around screaming and naked in the middle of the night.
Leela, we mustn't be so judgmental. We mustn't show prejudice.
Where is the prejudice? I was just describing what happens outside our house every night. That's what we have been doing for the past half hour. All of us.
But until now, we didn't know what we were describing. Now that we've guessed, we can no longer use such words like running around naked in the middle of the night. It sounds so critical and judgmental. Supposing I described the holy mass of the Catholics as eating wafers, or an abhishekam as pouring liquids over a piece of stone. Wouldn't people get offended?
Shh! Wait a minute. What's that I heard? Isn't that them? Isn't it time for it to begin?
Yes. It is. Frida! The candles! Put out the lights and draw the curtains! Come. The dinner's on the table. Let's eat.
She does all the cooking.
Well, under my supervision.
She's good.
Oh, all right. Been with us a long time.
So,
you know, I don't care what it is. Religious ceremony or whatnot. I hate this song. I hate it.
Really, Leela?
No. I see your point, Maskal. The actual sound of it is unpleasant. Sets my teeth on edge.
It'll go on now for at least another half hour.
So, we eat first and then...
What? You are still going to watch?
But now it's a clear case of sociological concern, a duty.
You know best. Frida, the children had dinner.
I thought you said they were asleep.
I keep them locked inside the guest room so that they can't see this thing. Usually they just fall asleep before having their dinner.
Now that we know the cultural significance of the spectacle, perhaps we should let them watch.
No! That I'll absolutely not permit. Whatever the secular laws of this country, I will not let my children be harmed by such disgusting sights.
I don't understand how you can be so intolerant.
I don't care what it is. All I know is that it is shocking and should be stopped.
And you haven't even seen it.
Besides, what about the harm they suffer from being cooped up in one little room all evening?
I don't care what it is. As long as there is that going on, they are going to stay locked up inside.
You would prefer that our children become mindless vegetables than that they...
Who could that be? Is this on?
Are we expecting anyone?
No! No, it's on! Should Frida open the door or not?
Tell her to put the chain on, then see who it is.
Frida, put the chain on! Don't let anyone in!
She's impatient, whoever it is.
It's also frightening.
Hello. Hi,
it's Naina.
Oh, sorry. You started your dinner?
No, it's fine. It's fine.
Naina, what a pleasant surprise.
Long time no see, Bhaskar.
Won't you join us? Frida?
And... What brings you here at this hour?
Oh, come on, Bhaskar, it's only 9:30.
Please, Naina, I'll get Frida to bring plates. And where is Surinder?
Thanks, don't bother, please. We've already eaten.
I have something.
No, really, Leela, don't bother. We thought we'd take a chance.
You should do that more often.
I should. It's been such a long time since we dropped by. Remember? The last time was when... Wait, wasn't there a power failure then too?
It's not a power failure.
Then why the candles? Someone's birthday?
No, but have you met? This is Mohan Ram, Naina.
Hi.
Hello.
Naina and I were school friends.
Don't say that. It makes me feel ancient.
We are all ancient these days.
So, where is Surinder?
He's gone to get some petrol. You want to run short on the way home.
You'll have to go quite a distance. There isn't any place close by.
So how are things, Naina?
Oh, fine. I wanted to bring Shashi, you know. But I thought the children might be asleep by the time we get here.
Yes, they go to bed early these days.
How long it's been? The flat's looking so different.
Seen any movies lately, Naina?
Nothing. Not even on TV.
And Surinder, how's his, the business?
Didn't he speak to you yesterday? He's quitting his...
Oh yes, I remember. He mentioned something about expansion plans. Maybe I'm mistaking him for someone. I remember. Is that... what's his name?
What's that?
What?
That? Didn't you hear it? It sounded like someone calling for help.
Oh, I don't hear anything.
No! See? It sounded like... coming from there,
or
from outside.
It's nothing really, Naina. Just
it's some sort of religious ceremony, you see. The local slum dwellers putting on a program.
Religious ceremony? How strange. I mean, what festival is it? I mean, are you sure? It sounds more as if someone is calling for help.
That is what it sounds like, but...
I'll just take a look. You never know.
Nana, I think you should sit down.
Why don't you just explain? You look so bad in your eyes.
It really doesn't sound religious.
That's what I say.
We all agree it sounds bizarre. Not at all religious. But then, drums sound quite awful too, you know. During these festivals, when they keep on beating their drums all night.
Oh yeah, I hate the drums too. So insensitive they are.
And imagine what effect it must have on people who are ill.
I mean, does it? I don't know, but doesn't it sound? What is the sound is really calling for help?
It's part of the ritual, you see.
But what ritual? Can't I just have a look? I mean, I'd like to see for myself what they're doing.
Nana, I wouldn't. I mean, seriously, it's better not to watch.
Why? Don't tell me it's bad luck.
Yes, that's just what I mean. It's bad luck to watch these things.
Bad luck?
Yes, with certain religious rites, non-believers aren't meant to watch.
Are you serious?
But then, what about the light? Why do they do it out in the open? Why do they break our windows if they don't want to watch?
Windows?
Frankly, Nana, this is really something we don't want to talk about.
No, I think I must look.
Really, Nana, it's not worth seeing.
But I must. I can't bear to hear the sound and not look. Even if it's something religious, it sounds as if it should be stopped.
That's just what I think.
Nana!
There, I told you, it's better not to see.
Someone's me.
No. Don't say anything out loud. Leela will get upset.
Someone's me. There's a woman. Me.
Wrapped around by the foot.
Do you think it can be part of the ritual, Mohan?
What ritual? That's no ritual. It's a...
Shh. No. You see, Leela's hypersensitive these days, and I don't want her to know.
What can you mean, seeing? It's a ritual. We must do something about it. Get it stopped. Call the police.
Shh. No. You see, it happens every day.
Every day?
Well, every night, around this time.
You mean it's some sort of a show? It's not real, it's just some sort of... No! It must be real! They really were naked! What are you saying?
There is nothing we can do about it. We just have to ignore it.
No, we don't! We can call the police!
Then she knows?
No. She's only heard the sound. She's never seen it.
Almost.
See, they're kicking her.
Yes. in the stomach and in the chest and in the face.
And there, now, they're hitting her with their fists, aren't they?
Yes. That too.
And now, they're holding her legs apart.
One man, each leg, spread wide apart. They are more susceptible.
The weaker sex, after all.
It's a rape. It's a rape. Isn't it?
No.
Of course not.
Not at all.
What proof do we have?
What proof do you need? Just look outside the window. You'd see them at it.
So, we are listening to the thoughts of a woman being raped. Outside our window. Under the light.
Don't overreact, Leela. It's almost definitely an exorcism.
Don't you see? That would explain why this is being repeated night after night. You know, I read somewhere that all these demonic possessions, they have a pattern of sorts.
Though, you know, as it's a different woman every night, it's rather unlikely that they'd all be possessed by the same very punctual demon.
You're mad! Both of you! You're talking nonsense! Just one look outside the window, you know it's rape!
Oh, you must have seen a lot of rape, Nana, to recognize it at one glance.
Three men holding down one woman with her legs pulled apart while the fourth one thrusts his organ into her. What would you call that? A poetry reading?
But the beating then, the brutality. If all they wanted was a little sex, why would they go to the trouble of so much violence?
Most forms of rape, especially gang rape, are accompanied by extreme physical violence.
But are all the rapists normally naked, like these people out there?
And do they do it like this, under the lights, in front of decent, respectable people?
And do they repeat the act night after night at the same location?
I don't care what it is. I want to call the police and have a horrible nuisance stop.
And listen. There's one more important consideration to be taken into account.
What? What's left?
She could be a whore.
See? A whore?
Of course.
That's what she is.
Of course. She's with four men at once.
Is that enough to prove that she's a whore?
A decent woman would never be with four men at once.
But she could have been abducted from somewhere, been brought.
A decent woman would never submit to this sort of thing.
If she's a whore, does it mean you won't call the police?
If she's a whore, Leela, then this isn't rape. So on what grounds could we call the police?
Why? A whore can't be raped. Is that the law?
Oh, come on. After all, what is rape?
Rape is when a woman is forced to have sex.
And what is a whore?
A whore is...
A whore is a woman whose whole livelihood is sex.
A whore is a woman without shame.
But... does that mean that only decent women can be raped?
Of course!
After all, what does a whore have to lose?
Why? I mean...
Listen, a whore is not decent, so a whore cannot be raped.
But then, if only decent women can be raped, what is the point of being decent?
She's getting all confused.
What are you saying, Nana?
Listen! Listen! You see that out there? Now, that is the point of being a decent woman. You see, if she were a decent woman, we would go to her rescue. She is not. And so, she's being left to her fate.
Surely. I mean, even a whore has the right to choose her clients.
Choose her clients? A whore just takes what she gets.
Whatever rights a woman has, they are lost the moment she becomes a whore.
Oh, horrible it must be to be a whore.
You mean, if she's a whore, there's nothing we can do about all this.
What's there to do? We can either watch or not watch. That's all.
Why should we get involved with some filthy woman and her paramours?
Why are we sitting here talking about these? Why can't we call the police?
Listen, the woman's not just being raped. She's being brutalized as well.
Where is the question of rape? I don't know.
Look, these things go on all the time, all over the city. Who are we to interfere?
Please. Let's look for the police and be done with it.
It's just that this time, it's happening right in front of you. That's all.
That's the only difference.
You think these things happen all the time?
All the time. It's going on. Whores, pimps, prostitutes, violence.
It's a hard world out there, Nana. A hard world. People like us, there's just no contact at all.
Even on this? Four men at once, beating, hitting, kicking.
I mean, who knows? Who knows how these people live?
They're like animals, really. Decent people like us, there's just no contact at all.
Listen, supposing she isn't a whore?
How do we prove it either way?
Surely there must be some way of telling a decent woman from a whore.
It becomes difficult once their clothes are off and they're covered in blood and filth.
What sort of clothes do these women out there wear? That should tell us something.
Oh, rags usually. Dirty bits of cloth.
Well, that doesn't sound much like a whore, does it? I mean, I thought whores were gaudy and vulgar and...
Depends what kind they are.
The poor ones are quite tattered.
And they must be poor, or else why would they submit to this sort of thing?
Leela's right. It must be terrible to be a whore.
Terrible, yes.
They live on the outer limits of human society.
In a jungle of shame and disgrace.
We must call
by losing their vulnerability to rape, whores lose their right to be women. Is that what you mean?
Right. After all, finally the difference between men and women is that women are vulnerable to rape.
And men are not.
And women believe they are vulnerable.
And men do not.
Please call
and
the police.
Women are decent enough to be raped.
And men are not.
Please.
After all, what is a woman but someone decent enough to be raped?
And what is a man but someone too indecent to be raped?
But if men are too indecent to be raped, does that mean that men are whores? Quick! She's in
water!
Leela! Leela!
It's okay.
Don't take it so hard, Leela. No one's going to hurt you.
I told you, she's hypersensitive.
Here, drink this.
No! I don't want any water. I want the police. I want the police.
All right, Leela. All right. I'll call them right away.
You promise?
This minute.
After all, whatever this is, it's a nuisance and it must be stopped.
Think of the effect it's having on youngsters.
Which police should we call?
Dial 100, I think.
But that's the general number. I think we should call the police of the district.
Tell them we are being tortured by some gunda!
But that's hardly true now, Leela. Who would believe such a complaint?
I don't care what they believe! The sounds torture me! Tell the police! I can't sleep at night. Tell the police, the gundas must go away and take their dirty whores somewhere else. I don't care what they do, who they are or what they are. I want them far away, out of my hearing, out of my life.
She's right. It's an assault on all of us to be able to see them and hear them like this.
I've call the police?
Yes, yes. I'll call them right now.
Oh, that must be Surinder, of course. What an age he's been.
Hello?
Oh, Surinder. Thank God you're here.
Why?
It's Leela.
She's hysterical.
What?
We have to call the police.
The police?
Because of some gundas outside.
Gundas?
There are some gundas outside with a whore.
And the sounds disturbed Leela so much that she became hysterical.
Really? It's a terrible incident. The whole thing.
It's been going on for weeks now.
But
take a look outside. You'll see.
Expecting anything. We'll tackle one at a time.
What about the chowkidar?
We'll give him a knife too. Let me see.
Oh no, they're too blunt.
Here, what are these?
Steak knives.
Are there three?
There are six.
Won't there be a lot of blood?
We could take some towels as well. These should do.
Sundar, please. Now stop all this nonsense.
Shut up! I'll kick your teeth in. We'll take these.
Listen, I still think knives are not the best way. They're too direct.
What do you mean, direct?
With knives, we'll have to overpower them, struggle with them, catch them by surprise. And supposing they turn on us by chance?
Ooh, it'll be so dangerous.
So what do you want to do? Wait, how about petrol? We can go and throw some petrol on them.
No, no. Supposing we blow up as well?
Ooh, be careful.
So tell us then, what the hell do you want us to do?
Well, I was just thinking, how about acid?
Is there any in the house?
Leela, is there any acid?
Acid? Well, we need something to put it in, you know, like bulbs.
Ordinary light bulbs?
But the acid?
There's some in the storeroom. Frida, get a bottle, no?
A well-stocked house.
I'll just get a bulb. How many?
6, 7. Is it enough just to throw it at them?
Why 6? There's only 4 of them.
In case we miss,
maybe we could wait for them to come out of the compound and then throw it at them.
The risk of being seen is lower then.
We can take chances then, just in case.
But supposing someone catches us on the way?
So what? We'll just be carrying a few things.
Everyone carries knives these days.
Here's the acid. Oh damn, there isn't too much.
Hell, what do we do now?
We could make it a combination of acid and petrol.
I still feel petrol will be too risky. There'll be a big noise. And supposing something else catches fire, we'll be blamed for it.
Supposing you set fire to the woman as well?
Tell you what, we could follow them in a car and then run them over.
No, no, we'll never get all 4 of them at once. One of them might escape and besides, once they leave this place, what proof will we have that they were doing something for which they deserve to be killed?
Bhaskar is right. It'll be too difficult.
And besides, it might damage the car.
I say, how about a gun? Do you have a gun, Bhaskar?
No.
Guns are too noisy, yeah. Besides, who can shoot?
Here are the bullets.
Supposing we electrocute them?
Come on. That's much too complicated.
No, see, we'll throw some water at them, then we'll bring up a couple of fires and...
I have an idea.
What?
Your mentioning of guns made me think of it.
Meaning?
How about we go down there and take pictures of them, just as they are, naked and all, and then publish them in the papers.
Will that be enough to stop them?
Of course.
Don't you see? Once everyone gets to know that this is happening, maybe we could organize a public lynching or something.
I don't know. I still think we should beat them up a little.
Supposing we find out where they live and set fire to their huts.
Don't even say such a thing.
Why? Look what they're doing to us. Threatening us, breaking our windows, terrorizing our women.
Think of what would happen if you got caught.
You're all too old to be running around doing things like this.
You're right. Our priorities are all wrong these days. If we get caught, the civil rights people would be up in arms, defending these gutter scum.
But Bhaskar, what about the pictures now?
Who would print them?
Hey, come on, any newspaper. Pictures like these, even the foreign press would snap them up. I'm telling you, we'd make a lot of money. After all, how often does one actually see authentic pictures of a gang rape in action?
You've got a point. Such pictures must be very rare.
You're all too old to be running around doing things like this.
I don't know. I still think we should beat them up.
Okay, first the pictures, then the beating up.
If we are beating them up, then I think I have just the thing. Some steel rods. Do you think that'll be of any help?
First class.
But Bhaskar, how good is your camera?
Perfect. Focus, focus, zoom, zoom. I've been loaded a whole new roll of film just 2 days back.
And a flash. We'll need one in this light.
Yes, that too. Leela.
Hi, in the safe, in my cupboard.
Good. Then it's decided.
And how do we get there?
We can take my car.
You don't have to bother anymore.
What?
Why?
You're too late. The screaming stopped. There's no one left out there.
What are you saying?
They're all gone.
Oh. Then it must be over for tonight.
This play is based on an eyewitness account. The incident took place in Santa Cruz, Bombay, 1982. The characters are fictional. The incident, a fact. In real life, as in the play, a group of ordinary middle-class people chose to stand and watch while a woman was being brutalized in a neighboring compound. In real life, as in the play, the incident took place over a period of weeks. And in real life, as in the play, no one went to the aid of the victims.